Hello again. Now we have the last part of our section. And I think we can start. Yes. So the first presentation, a very long title, assessment of hydrometeorological conditions impact on the combat troops operations, preparations, and conduct in the GEO information subsystems of the automated battlefield management system. And as I understood, the speaker of this presentation, Yevgen Burov. Yes?
Yes, it is me.
So you can start. Yes.
I can share my screen. So I will not, in order to conserve a bit of the time, I will not repeat the title of my presentation. Now, this is a joint work completed by a team of offers from the Polytechnic National University and the Hetman Petro Sagaidashvili National Army Academy. A bit of introduction. As a battlefield management system, provide information needed to efficient and effective operation of the troops. And the important part of this information is the information about weather conditions. Modern battlefield management systems are rather sophisticated. They provide a lot of information about weather, for example, about multiple up to four different weather parameters. They take in consideration spatial aspects, different locations and temporal aspects, low, short and long time perspectives, and so on. The purpose of all the research here is first to analyze the meteorological service requirements coming both from NATO requirement standards and Ukrainian armed force regulations. Next, based on this analysis result, we should assess different weather and geospatial services available to be used in such system, and propose structure and operation mode of such geo information and weather assessment system for our Ukrainian conditions. In the first part, it worth to be said that the algorithm and methods used now to support meteorological decisions in Ukraine's army do not always consider weather and their impact on the troops. As a rule, modern weather systems, they use a lot of provided data supplied by specialized providers. And we analyzed a couple of systems, for example, the systems ESRI, which is recommended to for implementation in the armed forces in Ukraine. And this, what is interesting, is the system converts a lot of different aspects and parameters of weather to free kind of assessment, like is the weather adverse or weather favorable, or this is on the threshold. This system, ESRI, is a rather complicated system. As already said, it analyzes kind of 40 different weather parameters and for different kind of troops, and provides the weather assessment for those different kind of troops, for example. Another interesting system for analysis is so-called my weather impact decision aid, which is which uses expert system based on rules. A lot of rules which allow to recommend decisions based on current weather conditions for different kind of troops. But as a general conclusion from this analysis, what we had found that all those systems have excessive complexity. They involve a lot of data obtained from specialized sources, and they are poorly integrated with existing information systems. So there is a need to develop where the prognostication and assessment systems for military purposes tailored specifically to our Ukrainian army in our conditions. In this slide, you can see the input providers or different ways to provide input about current weather states, ground-based stations, sea-based stations, and aerological synoptic stations and other stations which provide input data. In the process of our research, we developed the prototype of such service, which is currently available on the site shown below. And this prototype is only kind of a beginning and proof of concept. Here it provides a weather along the route, for example, along the route of movement of troops from one point to another point within the specific time frame and also distance. And the requirement for this such system is to be able to adapt to the change in functional models, be able to evaluate, provide calculations and prognostics for weather conditions, and be understandable to for officers, commanding officers. The conceptual model of the systems includes local reconnaissance, which provides data, initial data, and battlefield management systems provides geospatial modeling.
Yes. Sorry, but you have only 5 minutes.
Okay, I will.
So you need to present only main idea of your presentation.
Okay. I'm going to completion score. So this is the basic structure of our system here. And in this slide, you see in more detail how the system works. The data collection comes from different elements, and as it is put in the database, and the final decision is made by the officials. As a conclusion, we can say in our work we analyzed the different standards of NATO of requirements of our Ukrainian troops and developed the structure of battlefield management system taking in consideration weather conditions. And if you have any questions, you will be welcome.
Thank you.
I completed.
Yes, thank you. Mm-hmm. And do you have questions? Maybe somebody have a question to you again? No? Okay, you can please say me about maybe of course, I understood that I don't have a lot of information about your software, about your system, but analyze your other systems with the geolocation, with the all necessary information for army, for other department of our army.
Currently, our army don't have such a big some kind of developed systems providing meteorological information. It is provided by, it can be provided on ad hoc basis by different providers, such of existing meteorological services. So generally available information, I would say, and it does not include some assessment of impact over the troops operations, and this specifically military.
Yes, it's a very specific domain of your research. I understood. Yes, thank you. And
thank you.
The next presentation, the ontological decision support system. composition and structure determination for commanders of land forces, formation and units in Ukrainian armed forces.
Yes, it's me. Good morning. Okay. I'm glad to see and hear you.
Yes.
Let me start our presentation.
Yes, yes, you can start. Because in this subsection, we have a lot of presentation and research about military, about armor.
Yes, so. Yes, yes, yes. It's a very important same for this moment, especially yes. for Ukrainian situation.
Yes.
Yes. Do you see my presentation?
Yes.
Can I start?
Yes, yeah, you
yes.
can start.
Thank you very much. Now we have our the presentation made by Olesya Paraschetnik, Vasily Litvin, Vyacheslav Zhuchuk, Leonid Polishchuk, Victoria Vysotska, Zoryana Rybchak, and Yulia Pukoch. Now, the main purpose of the work is to determine the composition, the structure of the decision support system for commander of formation of units of the land force for the armed force of Ukraine using the ontological approach. Object is development is decision support system based on the ontological knowledge base, a prototype of software, mathematics and information support for it, offer for algorithm of function activity of the land force of the armed force of Ukraine from the battalion and above according to the US Armed Force Standard MDMP at each step of the military decision making process. Ordering the effectiveness of the necessary information for the preparation and conduct the hostess of commanders of formation, the units of the LF of AF of Ukrainian is possible under the condition building the ontology of military decision making order is a structured knowledge using certain conceptual or certain conceptualization. There are three types of ontologies: domain oriented, task oriented, top level. Usually the formal model scheme of ontology O by three of this kind is described in this slides. In general, the structure of the ontology is a set of the elements of four categories: concepts, classes, concepts, categories, relations, axioms, and instruments, individuals. Thus, the conception of the ontology are subject of the kind of hierarchy. At the lower level of this hierarchy are instead specific of individuals. Higher are the concepts, etc., categories. At the high level are the relation between these concepts. This element are entitled by rules and axioms. On this slide, we have creating the software mathematic information support ontology DSS in this proposed for the modular approach, which alone describes the set of this basic model. The upper level of this structure includes the known screen stage steps of the MDMP decision-making process, first level of the hierarchy, with the corresponding substage second of the level of the hierarchy. The task performed of this substage set a level of this hierarchy and the action of the commander, fourth level of hierarchy. With this proposed subject area, MDMP, a prototype of software mathematics and information support has developed, which is based on the development of technology DSS of commander for formation and units of LF of the AF of Ukraine. Figure 1 is structure of SLAMIS of ontology DSS of commander of formation of units of the LF and armed forces of Ukraine. In this slide, we have the example of the automated design of technology task as such as built during the work, which is presented in figure 2. The menu of the left displays the ontology model of process of work. Command is decision maker for combat, hierarchy for decision maker process of commander. The figure also saw the use of the built ontology to explain and describe the MDMP decision-making process according to the standard of NATO member countries' menu of the right. The given ontology of planning of the VERC's command is decision-making for combat operating integrated action of the commander staff, subordinate, attached, and interacted staff in order. Understanding situation of combat mission, develop the compare combat options or COA selection of the development of plan and order the performance of combat mission. Conclusion. The main further of the building of support system of commander of formation of use of the land force of the armed force of Ukraine, the second component which is the knowledge base are considered. The core of SASO, knowledge based on the ontology of subject of area, describes the position use the ontology for the structure presentation of the correspondent and decision making of the related components of the areas and describe it such as process. It is established that the SA of ontology is built of describing and explaining the decision-making process of MDMP according to the standard of the NATO member countries based on knowledge formalized in guiding document of information exchange, database structure, and software implementation of models, methods, and algorithm of individual DSS models. And this model and form of the of knowledge decision support system and commander formation of unit of land force of the armored force of Ukraine, a prototype of software, mathematics, information support and development, which can be used as a prototype of the future subsystem of the armed forces of Ukraine. The VERC algorithm process at the LF official of the Ukrainian armed forces from the battalion and about the coding standard of the USA armed forces, MDMP, is proposed. Automatically of each stage steps of MDMP gives a change that reduce the time of decision making. This is material can be using user introducing into the educational process of training officer and cadets of a high military education institution in the center of simulation of the latter of the youth in the decision making of a combat operation in training, catering and troops. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Miroslava. So if I understand, you have not very similar, but you have a related presentation in this section, yes? So yes, each, yes. Each of your presentation from Lvivska Politehnika is related with with one domain, yes, armor, yes, and yes, different, yes, part, yes, of software, yes. Okay,
yes.
So maybe you can present the next presentation,
yes,
and
yes,
I prepare some questions to you.
Okay, thank you very much. One second, I'm start my the next presentation. Did you see it?
Yes, yes, I see, but now it's okay.
Okay, okay.
Now
okay.
It's okay.
Okay, thank you very much.
Please, sorry, Miroslava, could you close your one software window, because
okay,
it's
yeah,
a shadow on the main presentation.
Mm-hmm. Okay, one moment, I will start once again. I'm shut up my last presentation and now start. Yes. Yeah, it's better. Is it better?
Now it's very good, yes.
Yes, thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce our research on topic on intelligent system for visual passenger flow simulation of public public transport smart city based on neural network done by Yuri Matsyuk, Miroslava Bublik and Victoria Vysotska at Lviv Polytechnic National University. In this slide, first, we all establish that this passenger traffic that this consists of the how it forms. The basic unit of passenger traffic is the passenger. The group flows of the passenger traffic is important for understanding the construction of road and their use by passengers. The purpose of this work is to improve the quality of passenger services by the assessment passenger traffic on road. The object of the study is a proposed the visual simulation of passenger traffic in the transport. The subject of study is the principles of visual simulation of passenger traffic of the public transport. This table shows the company's characteristic of three similar software projects. Each of them presented its special market segment. For example, A plus C Ukraine is the company that only provided research and visualization of passenger flow, but does not provide information of what software tools is used on the company websites. You can find only one screenshot of the type visualization of the passenger flow. Next site is text.org. UA, which is then provides the information of e-tickets sold by the latest data was updated in January 2019. And the last of this is the software products, PTV Visium Germany is an incredibly large and multifunctional tools for studying not only passenger traffic, but also traffic, but its product has one of the biggest downsides. Namely, the price of this product in Ukrainian hryvnia is 2 million per 100 kilometers of the studied road. And for example, the length of the usual trolleybus road in Lviv is 20 kilometers. A more detailed comparative characteristic is given in this table. Main idea to visualization similar passenger traffic of the public transport road aspects, the general goals, constructions, the dynamic and static simulation model of road and application of mathematical model criteria leaves is GTFS standard support, integration of Excel spreadsheet, intuitive interface into logical self support and other forecasting. So, analytical hierarchy method was used for select the system of type. The slide shows a hierarchy of characteristics of international for system types. For example, we choose intelligent system is most suitable for this project because data interpretation, teaching, prognostic, decision support. Using this method, we can update for each matrix. We calculate the eigenvalue for the matrix one and for the eigenvalue of proximal well. The context diagram, EDEF zero functional diagram, is presented in this slide. And the next slide, we have the first level of the decomposition. And the next slide, we have the hierarchy of task of the form of tree increased by clicking of the tree. Now we present why the Python program language was chosen, how as a means of the solve this problem and of this method used in this project. We have imported two interface models for the graphic data visualization model. Although the interface model of the choice has made between Python Qt and Synthera is using the Python Qt was selected, the characteristic of which are given in the right table. Among the graphic data visualization models, the choice was made between the PA game and PI GLAD. As a result, PA game was chosen because it's better support to the rendering and is quite easy to use. Now on this slide show as schematic of the database in which GTFS data is stored. This project also views the neural network of predict change of passenger traffic of the route. An example of the structure of the neural network is shown in this figure, but the size of each layer is not static, but depends on the input data. By data in the field of the input of the neural network, namely our passenger traffic on the last race entered in vacant capacity, and at the input, we care the value of the new passenger loads. The main interface, this slide shows the main interface of the software product. To select the road, we must click on the drop-down list of the road field. And now we have choose the trial bus number 32, 32 trial bus road of the city Lviv was chosen for the test example. Selected road, and now we can get the view of the interface with the special selected road in this type of schedule, the start of the map button with start working on the map mode. The start button schematic will be start working in the schematic mode. And after linking the neural network, the visual schematic button on the right slide of the independent display is a result of this change. First, the map view is the traffic of the both direction. Two is the arrival of transport stopping disembarking for pickup passenger. Three is change the speed of the visual simulation with the display as a service information is the HUDI in the lower right corner. And zoom four is the zoom the map of the road which display the service information of HUDI in the lower right corner. Now five, we have the vehicle that is on the lunch break. On this slide, we view the schematic mode is shown on this slide, and the spheres, this mode we have can get this information. Now, in drop-down menu, we can provide the information about the status of the stop, the selected time period. A drop-down menu of the race, which provides information about the status of the road of race, of its parameters, general information about the roads, and etc. Yes, and the red indicator of this segment in which patches the traffic has described or not change, a green indicate increased passenger traffic, example for comparison. And the conclusion of this our project, our the key role of visual simulation passenger flow improve the quality of passenger traffic has been established by functional diagram of IDEF 0, IDEF 3 has been created. The choice of programming language for this project is substantive. Development of an algorithm for dividing road of the formal and reverse side placement of stop of the road, unique algorithm of the using simulation of the map, schematic development created a software product for visual simulation of passenger traffic in real conditions for a casting change in passenger traffic using the neural network. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Miroslava. I have some comments. The first, on your second slide, you have text.org UA. Yes. Such company.
Yes.
And as I know, they use neural network for text text processing and analyze text. As I know, because I watched some presentation from the some guys from this company.
Oh, it's very interesting.
For us,
yeah, thank you.
Yes,
you
yes. And another, it's related with your software. Of transport, as I understood, you apply this software for Lviv
yes,
transport.
Especially
yes?
For trolley bus number 32. Maybe somebody live in this region. It's very interesting. Oh,
we have free software, such software for Kharkiv. And if it's interesting for you, you can compare your software with it's not me software, but we usually use this software for trolleybus, tramway, etc. You can see the number and where you can stay. What is the bus station near with this transport, etc.
Thank you very much for this proposal. Yes, it's very interesting. Thank you.
And so we have 10 minutes. You can start with the next presentation.
Yes, I can start the next presentation.
I understood that maybe you need to some break, but I don't have anybody for the presentation. So let's start.
Okay, just a moment. I will shut down my previous presentation and start the next presentation, because my computer is not so powerful for so much presentation. Yes, and now start demonstration. Yes. Are you seeing me? Presentation? Are you seeing my presentation?
Yes, I see.
Thank you very much. Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce our recent on the topic change management of RADND quality cost in changes of the global economy. Done by Miroslava Bublik, Volodymyr Mikhailov, Yuri Matsilyuk, Tatiana Pikhniak, Andrei Selsky, and Ivor Hrebek. At Lviv Polytechnic National University, Khmelnytsky University of Management and Law, National Academy of Public Administration, and the President of Ukraine. Emphasizing the interest, urgency, and complexity of the topic first, let me say that global spending of R&D has reached a record high of almost $1.7 trillion, about 10 countries account of 80% of spending. As a part of sustainable development goal, countries have pledged sustainability, increasing public and private R&D spending, as well as the number of researchers by 2030. Business entities were chosen as the main driver of this innovative growth. Consequently, the biggest share of newly emerging demand of R&D is innovation drivers from business entities, which means that the cost of R&D for enterprise should be decreased for enterprise in order to provide sustainable and contain innovation growth in enterprises and necessary prerequisite of innovation growth of country. In this context of global transformation of the world economy, the tendency of actualization, the problem of application development of effective cost management tools in inherent is research and publishing both of countries with economies in transition and for developed countries. The main tools of the managing R&D costs are reflected in the work of the main foreign scientists and our Ukrainian also. The based on the study of the future of problem application of tools to reduce the R&D costs used in the development country is established that they are all based on state support innovation process. A particular United States does not include R&D expenditure related to trade and opening action as the almost of taxable income. In the United Kingdom, R&D costs are deducted from the cost of product services. In France, the effective tools was to provide a tax credit of the increase of development and research costs. The application of tools and method of R&D cost management is presented on the table. The algorithm of the estimation of R&D cost of enterprise is presented on this figure. The advantages of using tools of manage the cost enterprise is the research of development is the 10 entities as a new international market. The R&D expenditures of Ukraine enterprise in 2010-2019 are presented on this figure. The share of components expenditure of R&D of Ukraine enterprise in this period 2010-2019 is presented in this figure. The dynamic of R&D expenditures for the period 2010-2019 in Ukraine are presented on the figure. The correlation coefficient between the time series of total and external R&D expenditures is calculated. The value of the coefficient 0.66, which is indicates the slight impact on the total R&D expenditures. So the study of the period of share international expenditures in total R&D expenditures exceeds 75. The tools of reduction of the R&D cost is presented in this table. And the problem of application of reduction tools of R&D expenditures and the weight of the solution are presented in this table. And the result, thus, our conclusion is that in this process of entity companies in the EU international market, there were problems with the use of cost management tools such as the problem organization as project is the lowest cost in the situation with urgent need for saving prediction and the type of the cost and accumulation of resources. The complex interdependency between the research project and available resource, which complicity the choice the tools to find the optimal point between the level of cost and effectiveness of scientific development or R&D development and the reduction of the scientific return from the implementation of the program of scientific development, programmatic return, and name it. And the last, the problem of inefficiently of cost management by the method of the influence the termination of cost in the enterprise, which does not carry out actually research and development. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Miroslava. Sorry, I am not a specialist in this domain and I don't have questions for you. I propose to restart our session because we have only 3 minutes, okay?
Okay.
And to prepare, yes, you can start after our break, okay?
Thank you. Thank you, okay.